Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here and welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel if you're brand new. So today's video we are taking a look at Picniic. Picniac with two I's near the end, which is a complicated way of spelling it, but this is a family assistant application. It's an organizer to help you and your family to get organized and coordinated, especially when you've got loads of manic things going on, like, you know, your son might have a football practice and your daughter might have a ballet recital, and you know, there's so much, like, I can't even comprehend it. It is something that's been on my list for a while, mainly because a lot of you guys have been recommending to check it out, and I've been like, okay, I'm actually going to look at it, because I've seen a lot of people in the community with families, or even with their wives or husbands, using Asana to organize their coordination. And a lot of people are starting to move to likes of Cozy and Picniac to basically organize that element of their life. And of course, family stuff is pretty manic. So hopefully, guys, this will give you a nice overview. Now, it's something that, you know, in the future when I sort of build a family with my soon-to-be wife, hopefully this will be something that I move into. And when all of this manic stuff is happening, I can have that there. So I'm just signing into Picniac here. Now, the actual concept of Picniac is that family assistant. It tries to blend the event side of stuff, so calendar events, you know, activities, tasks, so things to get done, and data, so that you can have it all in one location, which is quite efficient. And as you can see here, I'm prompted by a family account. Now, your family will exist in one account. So you can see here, I've created myself. I don't have any other members, but you'll be able to see the concept. You can modify the edit here. So you can add birthdays, family role. In this case, I'm gonna call myself dad here. And you can add an email there. But I've got an account here, so I'm just gonna go into Picniac. And as you can see here, it creates this almost, to some extent, dashboard for your family to look at. I am really impressed by the application's design so far. That's something that was straight away very, very impressive. Now, there are some features in this overview that are locked. I'm currently using a free account, so I will overview what is actually locked and what isn't. So you can see here, the thing that isn't locked, you'll notice the locked ones have got locks on the corner, is the calendar. And this is something that a lot of people rave about. I really like how it's laid out. And as you can see here, it will give you a sort of preview, almost like a widget. I'm going to open the calendar here. And as you can see, I've got this gorgeous design. It can go week view, month view. And this is quite a nice view if you and your family go week by week. Now you see this big red plus thing, then you can click it and create either a reminder or an event. Now, what happens once you create an event is you can modify all of the details, and you can even assign it for more than two people. So let's say this is my wife and my son. There you go. So they're the two members there. And you can add them in. So for example, I want to put football. Poker night. I don't know. I'm not a dad yet. So I'm going to go on Saturday. And you can see here that I maybe want it to start a bit later. So I'm going to modify the time. And it's 1 hour. It's not going to be 1 hour. I don't think poker night would last that long. You can say you can select all night, all day. location. You can actually add a location. You can add alert, repeat, and any notes there. But in this case, I'm just going to save it. And as you can see here, for Francesco, poker night. And you can either delete or go back in and modify it there. Now, if I wanted to, I can view that on month view, 7 p.m. poker night pops up there. And of course, that's quite a neat way in organizing your calendar. And you can obviously skip in advance, and you can even skip back to today if you wish so. So it's quite an efficient process. If I wanted to add a reminder to that, let's say pick up strawberries. I don't know why I pick up strawberries for today at 3 p.m. Then that reminder pops up there, and it almost acts as an event in some sort of fashion. Now, if I want to go back to the actual like calendar layout, you can see that obviously it clearly says Monday, and that reminder will pop up for Francesco. And of course, when other people add them, they will come up there. And of course, on the day of the poker night, that will pop up there. Now you can see here, this is the sort of secondary element of it, is a to-do list application. Now you can basically get started adding to-dos just by pressing the plus button. You can either add a list or a to-do. Now, I just want to show you lists before. Lists is basically an area where you can add, you could be like a template shopping list. But in this case, it's got a list of like setup, for example. I'm just going to delete this one and add my own list. So I'm just going to add a list here. I don't know. I really haven't thought about this. Shopping list template. I'm just going to put shopping list. Let's say I want to add my wife in there as well because we shop together and mark as important. And then put a due date of Thursday and click done. So as you can see here, the shopping list starts there. So we can add start items here. So it could be like peas, carrots, broccoli. You're probably like, why do I need to watch all of this? You can use the timestamps below to skip past all of the stuff if you do want to. Here we are, the shopping list. Perfect. I've got all my items there. I actually haven't got it in this sort of view, but I can start adding to-dos if I want to. So here we are. I'm just going to add a to-do for me. I need to fix the garden door. And I'm just going to sign that to myself. I'm actually going to give it a due date of today at 3:15. PM. And you can see here another one pops up, and it's quite tidy in a sense. You can go over here and tick things off. So if I were to tick this off, it would just show up like that, and it's quite nice to some extent. And you can see all of the ones that are remaining left to do, and you can just see all the items that have been completed, which I guess gives you and your family a sense of completion to those. But let's just go out into this view. You can see that the garden door appears on my to-do list, and tap on Picniic Setup List. And I tick that off, and as you can see on this widget preview, it goes away, which is quite nice. So it's quite a nice addition. Now on this top right-hand corner, you've got Family News. And Family News essentially is an activity log, so you can start seeing all that your family's doing on Picniic. You know, it could be adding event, or completing a task, or even adding a new task. And you can even add little messages here. So, I could put a family message. Let's go eat a pasty tonight. Local delicacy again. I can post it, and that message appears here. Now I can add, if I wanted to, a photo, but in this case, I won't. Now I can go back here, and it will pop up in the top right-hand corner, which is quite nice. And I've also got special events, but again, this is locked. So maybe this is a good time to talk about the family plan, then go over some of the ones that are locked and talk about a few more of the free experiences. So the premium is called the family plan, and it's Picniic Premium essentially, and it locks all the features for the whole family. So annually it's $49.99, that's a 33% off. Again, you can use the code in the description below if you decide to upgrade, even if you just want a free account, or you can pay monthly $14.99, or if you want like lifetime, $250.99. If you're finding it a really effective system for your family, then this might be for you. Now, the free account basically consists of the newsfeed, which I just showed you, the family calendar, which I've showed you already, to-do list, shopping list function as well, search and save online recipes, and planning group events, which I think is a good amount of things. But the premium gives you access to a meal planner, giving you an outline for you and your family, the information locker, which will provide you with a way to store really vital, I guess, like medical information, finance information, maybe contact details, just like useful stuff that will provide you and your family some value. The family locator, which is another one, which is basically like Find My Friends. If you don't already have that feature, this could work well for just keeping an eye on all the family, where they are, which is quite important for maybe young ones who have phones. Special events, so you even get the likes of anniversaries and calendars pop up, and also integrations with Team Snap Sports, so you can see all of the upcoming activities, which is quite nice. Now I'm going to go over to this one here. So yes, I was mentioning you've got the access to the shopping list and the recipes, and you can also see other calendars as well. So you can subscribe to the likes of an Apple calendar, Google, AOL, Yahoo, Exchange calendars, and Reverse as well. So if you're wishing to do that, you can do so. But apart from that, everything else is locked. So you'll get all of those features down the side, but they will have a lock icon next to them. Now, just to take a look at shopping lists, you can add a store list as well, which is quite nice. So you can enter per store, which is quite nice. So for example, if I wanted the local one here is Morrison's, and you can start adding the items there. And you can even start over again, and it will give you new store lists each time. Now, the final element is recipes. You can basically search recipes here. So if I wanted to go find recipe, let's see if the pasty one's available, just out of curiosity. It will basically pull them from online sources, which is quite an efficient way of doing it, I guess, saving you a bit of time. It doesn't look like the pasty one's available, so I'm going to put maybe ice cream, because I'm sure there's an ice cream recipe knocking about. And it looks like it is a rainbow ice cream pop recipe. And that's from a site called Serious Eats. So you can actually read it online or actually save it to your Picniic account. So if I go back, here it is. And you can actually love different recipes to give you an indication. So that will give you all the ingredients and revert you to the directions. Or you can write your own recipe with the ingredients, directions, and any notes. So if you and your family have a really important recipe that is very important to you guys, then of course you can do that. So just before we go, I'll overview some of the settings. You can add more family members here. You can change your password and details here, and you can change the family name as well, which is quite nice. And there's an upgrade button at the top. Make sure to use the link in the description, but you can also switch between family members too. So you can view it as other people, which is quite nice. So it's something that if you want to see, okay, you know, what's my sister doing this week? What's my auntie doing this week? I don't know how many people you can have there. You can actually do that in one sort of view, which is nice. Now, guys, I hoped that you enjoyed this feature. I'm guessing they're targeting their attention at children or at parents with children under the ages of 18. I think this is a very effective resource, especially if you and your family like just want to have a colorful place to organize all of your items. And it's definitely something that I know a lot of people will enjoy. So I hope that you find value in this one. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for stopping by. I hope that you enjoyed this feature. Let me know in the comments what you think. If you're not subscribed yet, hit the subscription button. And also, you can get 2 months of free Skillshare in the description below if you want. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for stopping by. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.